Okay, we're here at another garage, my friend's garage, and look at what we have on the other side of this rail. Wow. Chamberlain Whisper Drive. One of Chamberlain's finest openers. So it's a belt drive, and I think it's half horsepower. And then over here, we have a small door, and it's balanced, but extremely heavy. So, I recommend a chain or belt drive, depending on how often you use it. But today, I'm going to show you how to program a remote. I'll show you how to do safety and balance tests, and I'm going to lubricate them. But I'd like to demonstrate them for that. Okay, so over here is the wall control. It looks like a 78LM, but it's not. It's Chamberlain. It's the light. Open it. Okay. So here is the remote. It is a 953CW, I think. I'm not sure. But, close it from the outside for ya. It's so bright out. Okay, I'll open it back up. Okay, so I will go inside now and close it. Okay. Now I will demonstrate. So it makes a bit of noise when it's closing, but not much. And now I'll demonstrate the small door. Get so, like I said, it's extremely heavy. Okay, now I'll close it, but I'll leave it open a tiny bit. So see, it's balanced, but extremely heavy. Close it all the way. Alright. Now, I will show you how to program a remote. So, let me open the door. So, first, I need to erase the code. Let me pause and I'll do that. Okay, the clothes are erased. As you can see, nothing is working. So, to program it, we need to locate the orange learn button. Here it is. So what we need to do is press and release that button and press the button on the remote until the light blinks. Okay, now the remote is programmed and I will run the door down. Okay, now I am going to lubricate. So, here's our lube. It's the WD-40 spray. We're going to lubricate both doors with it. So when you lube the garage door, you need to make sure it's from the bottom up. To start, we're going to lubricate the end hinges and the rollers. Okay, so we need to, first let's do a bracket. So here to lubricate the rollers, you gotta spray like that. Get where metal touches metal. And now for the hinges, it's a bit more complicated. First, of course, you spray the rollers again. Then you gotta spray. And then around there. And I'll do the rest. Okay, now we're doing the body hinges. So we ran out of WD-40, so I have this oil. So now with these kind of hinges here, we need to pour right there, there, and sure you get where metal touches metal on moving parts. Sorry about the light, guys. So yeah, just make sure that you lubricate where metal touches metal on the hinge too. Alright, we've got all the hinges and rollers lubricated. Now I need to lubricate the spring system. So to lubricate the actual springs, well, 1 minute, I'll be back. Just gotta get the other ladder. All right, now to lubricate them, you simply pour the oil on them. So I'll show you the drums when I'm done with the springs. All right, now to lubricate the drums, once again, get where metal touches metal, so you want to pour in there, and then just a minute, get down there. The other side, you just spray it. Pour it where metal touches metal, just by the. Pour it right there. Alright. So now I'll do the other one quick. So the last step is to lubricate the. So with the T-rail, you lubricate the top rather than the bottom. So you just gotta drip it on top of here Jack, unfortunately, it'll be hard to videotape, so sorry. If you want to see it, you'll have to watch another video. And plus, it takes a while. All right, now I'll open it back up, and we'll hear the difference. Just look at the results. Now I'm going to lubricate the other door. But since it's pretty much the same, requires the same maintenance, I am not going to show you how to do it. All right, I'm done lubricating this door now. Let me show you the difference. One minute. Here we go. Big difference. All right. So, the next thing I'm going to do is a safety test. So, I'm going to put my foot in front of the sensor. The button. Light's gonna blink 10 times. Okay. So now we'll make sure it reverses. Okay. Works. Now let me find something. 2x4 piece of wood. Just a minute. All right, I think I found something that works. So let's try. Should reverse when it touches it. That is not good. That needs to be fixed. Stop it. So now I'm going to do a balance test. So thing you need to do is climb up the ladder. Then you pull down on the emergency release cord. There. And then straight down here. We don't need to reconnect at the moment. So now we need to put it in. One minute, let me figure this out. Alright, I got this figured out. See the trolley moving along there? Now, when that's moving, you're going to lift it now. Alright, let me. Let's see. There we go. All right.
looks like it is balanced. Now I'm going to reconnect it. So, let me do that. So, we gotta come up here. Pull down the trolley. I mean the release cord, and then it should reconnect just like that. All right. Thanks for watching, guys.